Hi everyone, it's Claire from Tablespoon, and today we are back with our 101 videos, and I'm going to be talking a little bit about sugar. So we cook with it, we bake with it, but what is it actually? That's kind of the question we're trying to answer. So I've got a couple of the most common sugars that you will find in your house in front of me. I've got granulated sugar, which is normally what you'll see with baking. It is 99% sucrose. It is usually made from either beets or sugarcane. Kind of two things that you wouldn't normally know. Sugarcane grows in humid temperatures, similar to bamboo. It takes about 18 months for the sugarcane to come to its full maturity for it to be produced. Both of them are produced in similar manners of basically cutting them up, putting them in water, boiling them until the sugars start to release, and then the refining process comes after that. And then we also have light brown sugar. So light brown sugar, you can either find it light or dark, and that really breaks down to just the amount of molasses that is in the sugar. So you'll see it can really change, and that is just the moisture level, because it is a less refined version of white sugar. And then you'll also find muscovado sugar, which is where none of the molasses is taken out. It has a much richer, darker flavor. From the research that I've done, it is usually recommended to put in any kind of marinades or sauces because it does have a very distinct flavor, very much like molasses. It can be used like as a substitute for brown sugar, but it's not going to be the same taste. We also have a confectioner's sugar or a powdered sugar. So versus the 99% sucrose that's in the granulated sugar, powdered sugar is going to be roughly 95 to 96% sucrose and 3% cornstarch. That's going to give it the powdery finish. Powdered sugar is just a heavily ground down version of granulated sugar. So if you are in your kitchen and you're like in the middle of baking and you're like, I am out of powdered sugar, I just did this the other day with some scones, you can actually take granulated sugar and blend it in a blender or a food processor. A couple of other types that we don't have here. So you're going to find like a caster sugar. So that is super fine. If you are making a meringue, if you're doing a cocktail, anything that you need it to be easily dissolvable, you're going to want to use a finer sugar. And then we also have raw sugar. So, you know, if you're getting your coffee or something like that, they're going to have something that's sugar in the raw. It's going to be a much coarser granule, but you're going to see a turbinado and a demerara sugar. I'm sorry if I do not pronounce that right. We tried to find lots of different pronunciations of it. So anytime that you're looking to kind of add a crunch to something, these are going to be great because they're not going to dissolve and they're going to give you a pleasant, crunchy finish. A decorator's sugar. So if you're looking for like a pearled sugar, sugar nibs, that's going to be something else that you want to do. Again, not necessarily something that you want to bake with, but something that is going to decorate or top. So if you like this video and you want to see more, definitely follow us on all of our social media channels, as well as check out our website, www.tablespooncookingco.com, for all of our upcoming classes.